divisé. Dans les interventions, il y a des soucis de tout le monde et comment. Et c'est le problème d'avoir un modèle type de communication.
In the discussions, there was the concern about everybody to have a model, a common model of communication, procedures, toolkit.
Et votre intervention, dès le début, vous avez annoncé parmi les moyens de communication, il y a les outils de communication, il y a la dimension au niveau du réseau, au niveau national et international.
In your invitation at the beginning, you were mentioning the need to focus on instruments, which national and international level.
Does anybody want to reply to what was the suggestion of method? That is, trying to list what we're using in different countries to see if there are common tools, common formats, common media, and where the differences are.
We use blog, external blog for this specific campaign. And so far it was not very successful. We did not mention a lot of signatures. I think that in Poland, direct actions would taking the signatures for the petition is more successful rather than the social media approach.
Okay. In the same line, we finished a research on migrants a few months ago, and it was very important to promote the outcomes of this research because they were referring to the public services and their role in what they offer to the migrants and the level of the services. And we wanted to promote this. What we used in order to invite the people to come was the Facebook, but there's also this the way to use Facebook. You urge your members to post in their profile the invitation and not just have it on your own organization's Facebook group or page or whatever. So when you post something in your profile, your organization profile in the Facebook, you also urge the other members to promote. This was a very good practice that we did. Also, we have a special mailing list that refers to media. So we are targeting to specialize messages, the media, and we use a different language for the media and a different language for the general public. This in order to target what we want. So specialization in messages is also very important in these cases. And of course, other practices we use was posters, invitations that we disseminated in our network, and they appear in places where we know that people will see them. So those are the basic tools that we used, and we can say it was quite successful, not so much for the general public to come, but for experts and the media to attend the presentation of the outcomes.
Yes, in numerous countries,
the
citizens are
not
It's a crowdsourcing tool, Ushahidi, but we modify it for special needs. If it's elections, it's service delivery, we're having a presentation on Friday, so I think that is one. Secondly, we use something called frontline SMS.
I missed the key word. I don't know what they're talking about. Radio or mobile?
It aggregates. It aggregates any feed. Ah. Even whether it's mobile, it can push an SMS to the web and onto a map. So I think, it visualizes the feed. It's been effective. It's been effective in those three countries because now it's the main election platform. It's going to be the next service delivery platform. So I think So I think that one is frontline SMS. Frontline SMS is simply a platform that you can. It works like your Microsoft Outlook, but you can plug in a GSM model. So especially for countries with difficult internet, you're able to. Especially as NGOs, you're able to communicate from your laptop to a wider group or to a wider audience. So That has been very effective. And it's free and open source. So a lot of these things I'm talking about are free. You don't need to buy or spend money around it. The third one is a comic.
A comic book,
but still ties to an SMS feedback mechanism. So we have an SMS number where you can publish a comic with case studies. And we call it a community of practice for us. It's not more or less a best practice, but people don't use that much. But simply a community of practice. How do you share a best practice in ways that people can interestingly digest? So the comic has been quite effective, and putting in an SMS number so that any person reading it can be able to send their story or send an email or try that to Facebook, Twitter, and all that. So I think that for us, the third part, the comic has been quite effective.
In most of the examples given by other colleagues, we have seen that there is some space in most countries, in most places, where civil society can play a role. But as I stated in my introduction earlier, my organization works from inside, which means we don't have any space to work within the country, within Eritrea. It's actually a situation where you don't have a single civil society initiative inside the country. So it's hardly difficult. We cannot use all these technologies like Facebook or SMS or other technologies. SMS, for example, is completely blocked from outside of the country. The only SMS service is within the country. So in our case, the most effective communication strategy thus far has been our radio broadcast, which broadcasts from outside of the country via shortwave and internet transmission. But still, it's very difficult for people to... sometimes it's jammed by the government. Sometimes people may not have easy access to what's broadcasted by the radio program. So I think the experience in Eritrea is quite different from many other instances in that there is a complete blockade in civil society organizations in the country.
So then how do you go about it, even if it's so difficult?
We are only discussing about the simple tools, I mean, whether it be radio or Facebook or Twitter or what. I'm expecting from this group that we should be discussing the communication in the broader perspective. For example, are we targeting the channels or the venues which we need to target? For example, if it's the girls' education issue in my country, and if it's Pakistan is signatories for the MDGs, is this forum going to affect somehow to UN through the communication channel? Then why Pakistan is not reporting its progress in the MDGs for the girls' education?
You should not forget the countries that are struggling with the most fundamental communication, lack of communication, like Myanmar, like North Korea, like other countries where usually the countries are those very human rights that we are all fighting for are the most affected or the most threatened. There is no SMS in Myanmar, there is no internet.
I do agree. And
worse than in
this is what I am saying, that if there is no communication within Myanmar, at least Social Watch should have the capacity and should know what can be done for that.